using a Sage ESN 2.8, 10 foot long. And I got a Nautilus featherweight reel with a Euro nymphing line. And I have 10 foot of maxima. No, I'm sorry, 10 pound. I have 10 pound maxima, about 4 or 5 feet from the fly line to the cider there. And I have about 18 inches of cider material. And below that, I have about 5 foot of tippet, 5X fluorocarbon. And today I'll be using this lightning bug, size 18 nymph. There should be some betas around this time of year. It's in mid-October. And I have size 12 rubber legs. Water is really deep in front of me. Oh, we got a fish. I didn't even feel that take. I remember these fish, they fight pretty good. Kern River Rainbow. Looks like he took the bottom fly. Is that size 18 kind of pheasant tail variation. They probably average 10-12 inches, and then they'll get an occasional 20 inch fish. This looks like a stocked fish. It could be a stocked fish from below that swam all the way up here. wish I had the net right now. I took the rubber legs. Good fish. It's about 12, 13 inches. Look at his jaw. Get this thing. I got him right where these currents converge. It's right in the middle there. Let's see if there's another one in there. Where this Euro line really shines, you can really cast a little longer with it. You don't get that line sag, so you get a better drift. Fish. Looks like I got two on. It's really treacherous walking around these rocks. Oh, very easy to do a face plant. They're both on still. Let's top guy off first. Lovely fish. That's definitely a wild fish. It's the Kern River Rainbow. Oh, first cast. Fish. this looks like a, not a pier, but it's definitely a Kern River Rainbow there. See the spots on his side. You have to sink in here before it starts drifting. Fish. It's a small little guy. Stonefly. Just kind of lift him up. There you go. So you took the stonefly. Fish. Thought I snagged. This guy took the bottom fly, but it's like a little bit of a tangle there. Ha ha ha.